Structural systems refer to the load-bearing structures, features, and facilities that are used to safely support and transfer the weight load within a built environment. Structural systems include foundations, beams, floors, walls, roofs, slabs, and plinths. If these exhibit signs of serious failure, meaning instability or collapse is possible, this could cause serious injury or death. While conducting NSPIRE inspections, look for structural system deficiencies in the outside, inside, and unit inspectable areas. Many components of structural systems have their own standards, such as walls, floors, ceilings, chimneys, foundations, and roof assemblies. When damage is discovered, determine if a structural system deficiency is also present. These should only be cited when there is a high risk of serious injury or death, such as pieces of concrete falling from an exposed beam or a deck that is not securely attached to the building exterior. For example, flooring is sagging in the unit's living room. If the floor appears to be structurally sound, evaluate the condition under the floor standard. However, if the floor is unstable and a resident would likely become seriously injured, cite a structural system deficiency. While outside, walk around the building as well as any areas participants can access, such as decks, patios, and playgrounds. The foundation, roof, and exterior walls must be in good condition and not bulging, leaning, buckling, or sagging, or have any large holes. Cite a structural system deficiency if it impacts overall stability and safety. Prior to accessing any stairs, porches, or walkways, look for any damage to main components, including underneath, if applicable. In the inside and unit, be sure to inspect every interior space the participant can access. Examine walls, ceilings, and floors, and check for any bulging, buckling, leaning, large holes, cracks, or signs where surface materials are failing due to support damage, such as beams or joists. If a structure appears to be unsafe, do not enter or approach it. Immediately inform whomever is on the premises of the danger and record applicable deficiencies. For every NSPIRE standard, review the health and safety determination for each deficiency. As a best practice for the HCV program, photograph life-threatening or 24-hour deficiencies for the inspection report. For more details about inspecting structural systems and other inspectable items, review the NSPIRE standards on HUD's website. To see more NSPIRE inspection videos and other training resources, visit HUD Exchange.